switching to manual flight controls. Auto sequence start in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
What's up guys, this is Blash from Racing Brick. Today is a big day and I'm super excited because the amazing LEGO NASA Space Shuttle Discovery is finally revealed. The set number is 10283. As you see, this is an 18 plus set and finally one where the black box design makes perfectly sense. The set has 2,354 pieces, we get the Space Shuttle Discovery in it and also the Hubble Space Telescope. On the back there are more details revealed, let's go through them. The Discovery is 54 cm long and 34 cm wide, just for comparison, the real one is 37 meters long. There's another detailed photo with the cargo doors open and the Hubble attached, we will check it in details a little bit later. There are two plaques for both the Discovery and the Hubble with some interesting data. Some additional photos towards the bottom of the box show the real Discovery, different views of the LEGO version, and an interesting play feature is teased here as well. Apparently the Hubble Space Telescope also gets its own little stand for display, there's a photo of the real one and finally the cockpit of the Discovery, which seems to be removable. There are a lot of things to consume here, but first a little history lesson. LEGO made several space shuttles over the years, some were pretty realistic, others not really. But did you know that LEGO already made a set about Space Shuttle Discovery? The set number was 7470, it was released in 2003 and had 828 pieces. It was created to commemorate the STS-31 mission from 1990 when the Hubble Space Telescope was deployed, so the brand new set is actually a bigger and more detailed LEGO interpretation of the same mission, which is quite unusual and interesting. The occasion of the release is the 40th anniversary of the first Space Shuttle flight on the 20th of April 1981. By the way, there's an interesting logo in the corner of the box, present both on the front and the back. There are two dates on it, 1981 and 2011, which is kind of weird for the first sight. I thought this is a misprint and it's supposed to be 2021 to mark the 40th anniversary I mentioned, but the last space shuttle mission, STS-135 with the Atlantis, happened in 2011, so I assume this logo marks the beginning and the end of the space shuttle program. So let's take a closer look at the features. The set has functional landing gear, and based on the comments of the designer, they are controlled by some mechanism together, but it is not visible at this point how. The payload bay doors are openable, and I think a new mold was used for them, although I'm not familiar with all the brand new non-technic pieces introduced, so I might be wrong here. The inner side of the bay doors are covered with reflective stickers to mimic the cooling radiators found on the real shuttle. At the rear of the Discovery, you can see the three main engines used for launching it into orbit. There are smaller engines next to them designed for in-orbit maneuvers and for deorbit and re-entry into the atmosphere. The flight control surfaces on the back edge of the wings are connected to one of the main engine nozzles, which adds some extra playability to the set, pretty cool. The rudder and speed brake on the vertical stabilizer can be also adjusted, although that one seems to be fully manual. The crew cabin features the seats in their correct placement for the astronauts on the STS-31 mission. Meanwhile, the mid-deck contains the space shuttle storage lockers for necessities and mission equipment, space for the fifth crew member, and the airlock to the payload bay. In the payload bay, you can see the robotic arm, the remote manipulator system or RMS. The payload bay also contains the Ku-band antenna for communications and cameras for the crew to monitor operations within the bay. The main attraction in the payload bay is of course the Hubble Space Telescope. It has its hinged mirror housing just like the actual telescope, a new gold foil solar arrays as well, and a realistic reflective metallic silver design. The telescope can be stowed in the payload bay ready to be connected to the RMS arm for deploy, just as it was on mission STS-31. As you see, we get a pair of these solar arrays in their storage position, and they can be replaced with the fully deployed ones. Here are some photos where we can get a sneak peek under the hood. We can expect a lot of interesting building techniques used with mixed system and technic pieces, and there are tons of details on the inside as well. Let's get back to the exterior and the overall look. Back in 2013, I had the chance to visit the Stephen F. Udvar-Hazy Center at Washington Dulles International Airport, which belongs to the Smithsonian National Air and Space Museum. This is where the Discovery is on display since 2012. This experience was really a dream coming true for me, and this gives me a chance to show you some photos I made of the Discovery and compare them with the photos of the LEGO set, just to show you the impressive level of detail and accuracy. I have to say that the designer did a fantastic job. Apart from the accurate overall look and dimensions, there are tons of tiny details from the original that you can see being replicated in Lego form. Obviously, the limitation of the material and the scale defines a lot of things, so there had to be some compromises, but it is still very, very impressive. I really like how the black tiles of the thermal protection system are accurately recreated, even at the less obvious locations. Although the number of the forward control thrusters does not match, but they are still there and look very cool. We get a special printed piece for the cabin window, but apparently other labels are mostly stickers. At the rear there are also some nice details, like the elements of the Space Shuttle orbital maneuvering system. Here are a few additional close-up shots comparing the details. All in all, I think this is a fantastic set and I cannot wait to get my hands on it. According to the press release, it will be available directly from LEGO stores and on LEGO.com from the 1st of April. You can see the regional prices on the screen. To celebrate the launch of the new LEGO NASA Space Shuttle Discovery, the LEGO group spoke exclusively to former NASA astronaut Dr. Cathy Sullivan to reveal details of her experience on board the original NASA STS-31 mission and how the real-life space shuttle compares to the LEGO model's detailed reimagination of the spacecraft and famous Hubble Space Telescope. Commenting on the set, Dr. Cathy Sullivan said, "I was thrilled to see the space shuttle in LEGO form and was very impressed by the amount of intricate detail they have managed to recreate from the module where we used to sleep and eat through to what we call the milk stalls of the telescope. Looking at the model, it was great to reminisce about my experiences in space launching the telescope for the first time. Hubble is definitely the highlight of my career." The fascinating interview is now available on lego.com/gobeyond. You can also find the link in the video's description. There will be two exclusive items offered for VIPs that they can purchase with their points. One of them is the Ulysses Space Probe, available for 1,800 VIP points, which the Space Shuttle Discovery also deployed in 1990 on a mission to scan the sun. Please let me know your thoughts in the comments. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up. You can also subscribe and tap the notification bell if you don't want to miss my LEGO reviews and other LEGO RC videos. See you next time, bye bye!